Hello viewers, welcome to another episode of MBTV Weekly News Roundup. We bring to you top 5 developments from Indian real estate space that's going to have a lasting impact on you as a consumer. I am Prasun Kumar, Marketing Head of Magicbricks, and with me is Jayashree Kurup, Senior Real Estate Journalist and Editor-in-Chief of MBTV. So Jayashree, a lot of action happening in real estate indeed, even on policy front. So the last announcement made by the finance minister in terms of setting up that stress fund, 25,000 crore, when do you see that starting to impact the delivery of homes and what consumers are expecting out of it?
Some announcements have been made, but right now a few more pieces need to be tied in so that the banks can start lending. Okay. Right? The RERAs have got their act together. Many RERAs have got their act together. The HFCs still don't have funds. And HFCs were the largest lenders to the real estate consumers. Unless the banks start lending to the HFCs, who can lend to the retail consumers? This entire stimulus package will only start when this money starts flowing in. And that we are still waiting for some more details. And I think while there is a lot of thought going on, we do need notifications from the RBI, from the government, from the finance ministries, commerce ministries, and actual on the ground, understand the problems and see how it can be sorted out.
And in the meanwhile, the details of these are being worked out.
That's right.
Who can apply for funds and who cannot.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So let's hope it happens soon.
Yeah.
All right. So the first news that we have today, it comes from Haryana.
Yeah.
Where Haryana RERA has acted and attached the land of 3C shelters across Gurgaon and Noida,
right,
and putting it up for auctions to generate money out of it. Now, good action and unprecedented in a way, because
Haryana had not. You've seen a lot of this happening in UP RERA.
Yeah, right.
You've seen some of this happening in Maha RERA.
Right.
But Haryana RERA, it's the first assertion that Haryana RERA has actually got really active.
Right.
And they have. This is a story that we have been tracking as MBTV also.
Mm-hmm.
We had consumers coming in, bankers coming in. We did address this issue.
Mm.
But the point is that there was land. And remember what the stimulus package is.
Mm.
It's cash flow positive.
That's right.
So when there's excess land,
yes,
that land can be sold and
yes,
that money can be inducted to completion of the project.
Right.
And that's the spirit of, I think the finance ministry's announcement has given all RERAs the impetus to go forward and get the money back to complete the projects.
Absolutely. And the fact that Haryana RERA not only looked at a developer and his assets based out of Haryana,
but also
looked
in,
at outside
in
Noida, which is UP RERA's jurisdiction, and has obviously they would have worked together to get this.
So there is collaboration between two RERAs to get this done.
Absolutely, that's wonderful news.
Yeah.
Now, we have also heard that the Real Estate Consumer Forum has written to the Prime Minister on unfinished projects, right? Now, consumer forums have been a part of the reconciliation process any which way, and it's good that they are taking a lead and becoming active and seeing to it that the projects that they have invested in goes towards completion.
Actually, Prasun, it's a very important news here. It's that many RERAs have not got their acts together, and the consumers are now protesting that it should not just be Maharashtra, UP and Haryana. You should be looking at RERAs where the RERAs have not got their acts together.
Right?
They've specifically mentioned Kolkata, where they refuse to tow the centers. They have something similar, but they don't have a RERA. So therefore, the stimulus package cannot impact there because there's no RERA there.
Yes.
Similarly, there are many other RERAs which have not really got their acts together, and the consumers feel that without an active RERA, they may be left out of this entire stimulus package.
Mm.
And I think we had a show last week where experts were telling us that it's not going to be from the top. The solutions are not going to come from the top.
Mm.
It's going to be the groundswell. People demanding that, look, there's money here.
Mm.
There's an incomplete project here. My money is stuck.
Yeah.
I need it sorted out.
Yes.
And I think this is a very positive move.
Yeah. And I think this pressure that civil society and consumer bodies can exert, this pressure should continue.
Absolutely.
Until the resolution happens.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. So, JY report is likely to be a reality, hopefully. And as a result of that, Greater Noida believes that its population could soar to up to 25 lakhs in about 10 years' time.
Right.
So development indeed having a positive impact and rejuvenating, you know, one sleeping satellite town there, and it will do a lot of good to the real estate and the prices of real estate and the overall development as well.
Yes, actually, Prasun, what has happened is that NCR, being a spatially growing city, most of it was concentrated on proximity to airports. Gurgaon did well, South Delhi did well because of its proximity to the airport. A new airport coming becomes a new driver, and another part of the town, where city, where there is more land to be developed, and there is a lot of housing stock that has been constructed here. So the now what you need is the economic drivers, and an airport is definitely an economic driver. And there are other means that they're looking for to get commercial activity going. So this is good for the city, and planning at this stage is much easier. The metro has already been planned. It's already got its the flyovers and things like that. So planning for the future is something that was missing in Indian cities, and I think it's a very positive move.
And that's critical, isn't it? Infrastructure should not follow development.
That's right.
Should be the other way around. And do you also see it having a positive impact on the entire challenged area of Yamuna Expressway and the Noida Expressway, where a lot of projects are stuck, or the Yamuna Expressway part where things were not even built, right? So J1 coming in, do you see, you know, real estate activity starting to pick up again, and you know, a lot of these things happen?
New corridors when real estate activities will pick up. And Yamuna Expressway, even though projects were sold very early, it was always known that its driver is going to be the Jewar Airport. The fact that the airport activities have now picked up steam, that's why there is this interest in actually assessing what kind of infrastructure you need, how much water, power, sewerage, drainage, you know, all this is important if the city has to work. And I think among all the Indian cities, Greater Noida is actually one of the best planned cities. It's just that its execution in terms of residential went awry because of various reasons. But I think it is well planned, and this move to actually plan for a 25 lakh population is a step in the right direction.
So for consumers who would have made an investment in Greater Noida, do you forecast that they'll have returns coming in because of all these developments happening now?
Certainly. It actually depends on what kind of commercial drivers come up, and it also depends on how fast the airport starts picking up and driving traffic. Now, if you have to, if you are a frequent traveler to certain sectors and that sector is being serviced by Jewar, there's no reason why premium living should not move in that direction.
Sure. All right. And another positive news, this time coming from down south Chennai. So, Chennai civic body, the Greater Chennai Corporation, has collected about 84 crores from regularization of unapproved plots, right? And we have been discussing about unauthorized colonies and those kind of things. But this is probably for the first time a civic body has probably started collecting, you know, regularization fees or something like that.
See, we saw this in the unauthorized colonies in Delhi, where they opened up registration and said, now you register and pay the amount. And it was a rationalized amount. The same thing in Chennai. What they've said is that if we are regularizing unauthorized plots, one, you should have never let it come because it is not part of the planning process. Having allowed it to come, now let's regularize it, get the money in for registration and penalties and things like that, and use that money again for that same thing that I said, water, power, sewerage, drainage, social and physical infrastructure.
Of that area.
Of that area. Unless the city, if it collects it and spends it somewhere else, then this whole exercise goes kaput. So I'm hoping that with what they collect from one area should be invested back in that area so that that area can...
Absolutely. Okay. And the last piece of news that came was Karnataka RERA, you know, getting active and starting to drive compliance, right? And there's a lot of brokers or agents who have started registering under Karnataka RERA.
Right.
That's an extremely welcome thing.
Yes. Especially in markets like Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, big markets where there's a lot of, you know, formal finance coming in to buy these properties. It's good that all arms of the real estate market are well registered and serviced. And, you know, the compliances are very important. And if you leave out brokers from that compliance matrix, then you can never fix that market. So I think it's, again, a step in the right direction.
Yeah. And for consumers, good news, because, you know, I mean, you're ultimately dealing with someone who has certain accountability defined for the, you know, entity, and therefore you should be better assured.
Yeah. You can go to the RERA website and check what the antecedents of the broker that you're using is.
Yes, absolutely. So, wonderful. So, viewers, these were the five top news from this week. We'll come back again next week with top five developments of coming week. Till then, keep tuned to MBTV.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Magicbricks on YouTube and click the bell icon to get new videos.